you know, the coffee production in my family, it started like 50 years ago. When my father was growing up, you know, he grew in a coffee region, and he started to work in other farms, helping other owners to produce coffee. When he was 18 years old, he went to the bank to get money to buy a little piece of land. And it was when he started to produce coffee. It was about 37 years ago. And little by little, my parents start to get more land, and they start to produce coffee. And they was conventional coffee producer. They provide the harvest or the cherries to other companies, other mills here in the region. But because of the low prices and international crisis, you know, they was not getting money enough to keep the coffee production. It was why we start to produce specialty coffee. It was in 2009, almost 11 years ago. And we start to produce specialty coffee because we knew that the conditions that the farm has to produce good coffee, I am talking about altitude, weather conditions, and variety we have in the farm. And because of that, we change a lot of farm practices to start the specialty coffee production. It was when I was leaving the high school, and I was taking the decision about what to do in my life. In the beginning, I wanted to be a mechanical engineer. When we start in the specialty coffee industry, I just fall in love with the coffee. I start to work together with my father to try to help my family to put the coffee in other side of the world. I was really excited. When you can see your coffee in other side of the world, and the coffee has all the traceability, the family name, and all the history of the family, it's really an honor, and it's a huge motivation. It's an inspiration because of all the job you are doing is being recognized. We're really working to provide better conditions to our coffee pickers. And we do the harvest with Panamanian people. They really do a good job picking coffee because of we have a long-term relationship with them. We really appreciate the job that they do. But we know that the conditions they have in Panama are not the best they can have. It's why we want to provide better conditions here in our farm. We have been building new houses, and also we provide them with beds, all they need to cook. Right now, we are working in the water project to give better water. When they are here, they feel comfortable, and they want to go back with all the good conditions. The dream I have is to someday help them to build houses, but in Panama, in their communities. And when they are here, they are always very excited about how much is going to be to build a house. You can see that they are interested to improve their conditions. So I met Scott in a coffee convention in Atlanta, and he just had like a dream in her mind. You know, in the beginning for me was like, okay, it's just another coffee roaster. But little by little, when I start to get more about Scott and Onda, I got to know that it's more like a project to impact to many people, and mainly farmers from around the world or countries that produce coffee. And when I got to know the other side of the business in Onda that is providing like impact in the coffee industry, for me was really innovative. I think they are able to impact in many farmers. The farmers, they work together with, and it's why I start to support them. I feel that it's not just to roast coffee and sell the coffee. It's more about impact in the people that are drinking the coffee. And when somebody is drinking the Onda coffee, they know that they are impacting in farms in many countries. And it's really interesting to know that there are companies able to support a project that we have as farmers. And when you can put all of this together, it's a better way to make possible all the projects we have. For me, as a farmer, it's not just about quality. It's not just about price. I think it's more about the relationship with the people, or how can I share how we do as a farmer to the people in the coffee industry. Yeah, for me, the coffee is not just about the quality. It's about all the things around the cup of coffee. All we do to produce the coffee, and everything about our workers and how we produce coffee in a eco-friendly and everything. The quality matters, but it's not all. It's more about how you can share everything around each cup of coffee, how you can share with the final consumer. When they are drinking the coffee, they have to be able to feel everything, the passion we have, everything. And it's why we have to have a really good connection and relationship with all the people in the coffee industry value chain and the roaster. And we do that, it's easier to share not just a cup of coffee, to share our history. I know it's not easy, but we are on the way.